Hey, what's up everyone? If you're looking to add a reliable and easy to use contact form to your WordPress site, then this video is definitely for you. Our first step is to choose a contact form. If this is the first time you've added a form to your WordPress site, then you'll want a form that's easy to use, but you'll also want one that can expand as your website grows, adding more features when you need them. For this reason, we highly recommend using WPForms on your site as it's the best form builder for WordPress. It's really easy to use, has lots of cool features and amazing add-ons. To install WPForms, you need to log into your WordPress site. To do that, head to your website and in the URL, at the end, just type /wp-admin and press enter. You'll now see the login screen and can enter your login details. Now that we've logged into our WordPress dashboard, we're going to install the free or light version of WPForms. To do that, we'd head over to the menu bar on the left-hand side here. And as you can see, there's plugins tab right here. You hover over that and then you click on add new. That then brings you to the add plugins page. And this page shows you all the plugins available in the WordPress plugins directory. And if you look up in the top right, there's a search bar right here and we can search the whole directory for any of the plugins that we want. So we're just gonna type in WPForms right here and click enter. And as you can see, this is WPForms right here. And all we need to do is click the install now button. And that's gonna install the plugin to our WordPress site. Once that's been installed, that button will now turn to an activate button and we can just click on that. That's now brought us to the welcome screen, so we now know that the plugin is now installed and activated on our WordPress site. If we head down the screen a little bit, we can see right here there's a button to create our first form, but most of the time we'll be creating a form by heading over to WPForms here on the left, hovering over that and clicking on add new. And now that's brought us to our setup page for our form. The first thing we need to do here is give our form a name. And then the next thing we can do is select a template from the huge template library that comes with WPForms. Now you don't have to use a template. You can start from the very beginning and use a blank form. And to do that, all you need to do is hover over blank form here and click on the create blank form button. For this video, and to make it super quick and easy, what we're going to do is use the simple contact form template. So to do that, we can hover over it. And as you can see, there's two buttons right here. There's a button to use this template or view a demo. So you can always view a demo of any of the templates that you want, which is pretty handy. So I'm just going to click the use template button. And now we've done that, this brings us to our drag and drop form builder. As you can see, the template has done all of the work for us and we have a pre-built contact form ready for us to hit save and use. But before we do that, let's take a quick look at the form builder so you can add any other fields you like to this contact form. So the form builder is divided into two sections. There's the field section here on the left-hand side, which is where you choose all your fields for your form. And next to that is the form builder where all your fields appear and they can be dragged and dropped into place and selected as well to change any of the settings. So if you hover over any of these fields, you'll see that you get a little tooltip to let you know that you can click to edit and your edit settings come up here on the left hand side. If you click and hold, you can drag any of these fields to any place you want them, which is really handy in organizing your fields. So if you click on a field, you can change any of the details here on the left-hand side. So you can change the label and the format. So you might want a more simple format. And if you look at the label right here, you can see a little red asterisk and that's the required field right here. So we can make any of these fields required and they have to be filled in by the user. So let's say for this example, we wanted to change the label for this just to message. So we could just delete the start of that and then make it required as well. And we can also change some of the settings for the submit button as well by clicking on that. And then we can change the text here to whatever we want. So now the button will read send message. Once the button's pressed, it'll show sending. And we always want to make sure that we enable some sort of spam protection for our contact forms to prevent any misuse of the form. So now we can click save to save that. So we head back to the field section. For this contact form, I'm going to add a multiple choice section. So I'm just going to click on that. And then I'm going to edit this by clicking on it. I'm going to change the label to how did you find us? My first choice will be Google. My second choice, social media. And my third choice, So there someone has a multiple choice question just to let us know how people are finding us and our website. Once that's added, I'll click save up here to save the changes. And that's how we build a contact form using WP Forms. Now that we've created our contact form, our next step is to set up the form confirmation and notifications. To set up our confirmation and notifications from the form builder, all we need to do is head over to the left here, hover over settings and click on that. And first we're going to set up our notifications, so we're just going to click on that here. So this is the notification section of our contact form. For those that don't know, notifications are basically emails that are sent out when the form is submitted. So with WP Forms Lite, you get to send out one email notification. And by default, this is set up on every form that you create to send to the admin email address. So that's the admin email address for the WordPress site. So whatever you've set up there, that's where this email is going to go to. You can change that if you want or add in other email addresses as well. You could delete this tag for admin email, or you could add another email address in by just putting a comma next to it. So if you add the email address in that you want, it will also send to that email as well. But I'm going to leave it as it is. So for the email subject line that we receive, that's set up as new entry for the name of the form that we've created. So that's contact form. Now you might have noticed to the right of these notification fields, there is a link to show smart tags. And if you click on that, you'll then see that you can add in specific details from the fields that have been entered by the user. So for this subject line, we could add in a dash and then add the user's name to this subject line. So it now would read as new entry contact form dash the user's name. And that's pretty handy for filling out these details on the form, as you'll see as we go down. So here we've got the from name, so we can change that to our website or whatever we want to let us know that this is a notification from our site. The from email is set up as the admin email address, but you can also change that as well. Because our admin email address does not match our website domain name, WP Forms is letting us know that this may cause our email notifications to be blocked or marked as spam. And we can change that by using WP Mail, SMTP, or adding a from address that matches our domain. Just below that, we can see that our reply to email address has a smart tag in it, and that smart tag is for the email field. So the email field that the users filled out is the reply to email address for us. So when we receive this email to our inbox, we can reply to that email and it will be sent directly to the user. And then our email message here is going to show us all the fields that are filled in by the user so that we can use that information to reply to them or answer any of their requests. So I'm just going to leave it like that and then click on save to save the changes. So now that we've set up our notifications, we're now going to set up our form confirmation. So all we need to do is click on that below notifications here on the left. So this is the confirmation screen for our contact form. So once a user's filled in all their details and then clicks that send message button, they're going to see a confirmation, and we can choose what they see from the settings that we select right here. So the first thing here, we can choose the confirmation type. So that can be a message, show a page, or go to a URL. So it's currently set to a message. And then below that, we can type in the message that we want. So we can change this default message to let someone know that we'll be in touch with them within a certain time frame. But if we choose the confirmation type to show a page, so this is great if you've created a thank you page to be shown after the user submits a form. So we can choose the page we want by clicking this little drop down and choosing any of the pages on our website right here. We can also choose a URL to redirect to. So if we want to redirect someone off-site or to social media or something like that, we can add that URL in here and the user will then be redirected after they submit the form. So I'm just going to select a message because I want to show a message. I'm going to keep the default confirmation message. To save that, all you gotta do is click save in the top right. Now that we've finished setting up the contact form, our final step is to add it to a page or sidebar on our website. So to add the contact form to a page on our website, we first need to exit the form builder. And to do that, just make sure you've saved your contact form. And then once that's done, you can click the little exit button right there. That's going to bring you back to the WP Forms overview screen, and we can see that our contact form is right here. To add it to a page, we're going to head over to pages over here. Now, if you don't have a page already set up to add a contact form to, You can always add a new page by clicking this button right here, and you can then start creating that new page to add your contact form to. I'm going to add mine to an existing page, so I'm going to go to my Contact Us page and click on Edit underneath that. So that's now brought us to the block editor for our Contact Us page. To add WP Forms to this page, all we need to do is scroll to the section that we want to add WP Forms to. I'm going to add WP Forms just under Send Us a Message just here. So to add the WP Forms block, just come up to the block inserter up here and then click on that. That's going to open all our blocks up here on the left-hand side. We can click in the search bar here and search for WP Forms. And that's brought the WP Forms block up here as well. And then if you click and drag, you can drop that into place. So I'm just going to drop it just here. And then as you can see, there's a WP Forms block. And right here, we've got a little drop down so we can select a form. We've only got one form on our website, so we're going to select the contact form just there. And just like that, it's added the contact form that we've just built to the page. If we click on that, we get a couple of options here on the right hand side. So we've got some settings that we can change, so we can show the title if we want to of the form. And if we've written the description, we can show the description as well. Once you're happy with how the contact form looks on the page, then all you need to do is click the blue update button here and that will save the changes. And if you click preview next to that, and then I'm going to preview it in a new tab, I'm just going to click on that. And now we're on our Contact Us page. We scroll down a little bit, we can see our contact form where we placed it in the block editor for this page. And with WP Forms, you get a sidebar widget as well that you can use. So we can add our form to a sidebar on any of the pages if we don't want them to be specifically on a page. So to do that, all we need to do is head over to Appearance, hover over that and click on Widgets. And this is the widget screen for our site. As we can see, we've got our main sidebar here. And if we want to add something to our main sidebar, we can either click on the block inserter here, or we can hover over any of the sections and add a block in there. So I'm just going to click on that. And then we can see we've got WP Forms right here. But if we couldn't see it, you can search for WP Forms in the search bar as well. So just click on WP Forms. Then just like we do on a page, we can click the drop down here and select our contact form. If you want to see the options for the block, you can click on the little cog, which is a settings button up in the top right. And I might want to show the title for this form in the sidebar so that people know what it is. And then once you're happy with how the contact form looks in your sidebar, just click the blue update button at the top right and that will save the changes. And to view the sidebar, I'm just going to head to my blog page. Just going to click on view. And then if I click on a blog post, I'll be able to see the sidebar at the right of the screen. Just there, so we can see our contact form. So that is how you add a contact form to your WordPress site. I hope this video has been super helpful to you. And if you've got any questions about adding a form to your website, then let us know in the comments below. Feel free to hit that like button and click the notification bell to make sure you see more of our videos when they're released. I highly recommend watching this video next. Thanks for watching.